Hey, and welcome to the Rugged Rundown. And today I'm going to give you the five things you need to think about when you're buying a rugged laptop. So it's kind of a buyer's guide. I want to tell you all about it. The first thing you need to think about, of course, is the power of the laptop that you need. So how do you determine the specifications that you need and the power? Well, you've got i5 processors, i7 processors, you've got DDR3 memory, DDR4 memory, M.2 hard drives, and standard SSDs. Here's what you need to do. Don't get caught up in all of the specifications. Check the software that you're running, whatever that specific software is that you need this machine to run. Find out the recommended specs and go into it and find out, you know, which unit will fit your specifications that you need. Not one is not better than the other unless it doesn't fit into your software requirements. Another thing you need to know about in the rugged laptop business is the various brand names that are out there for sale. And I have some examples here. For example, I have Panasonic Toughbooks. I've got the the FZ55, the CF33, and the FZ40 sitting here. I also have a Getac, and I brought this out as an example. This is a fully rugged Getac V110. So I say, there's also Durabook that sells ruggedized laptops, as well as, believe it or not, Dell has a line of ruggedized laptops as well, like the Latitude 5420 and 24. So when it comes to brands, all you need to really know is that Panasonic is the flagship. That's the one that if you purchase it, you may pay a little more, but there's going to be a lot of spare parts available for it. It's the most common rugged laptop that's available today. If you buy a Getac, they're not as common, and the spare parts are a little harder to get. Durabook, same situation. Dell, believe it or not, spare parts are abundant in some cases, depending on the model, but you still have plenty of units for spare parts. So number three is cost. Basically, what is your budget? You need to determine what your budget is. So for example, if you can buy brand new and you want to buy an FZ40, guess what? You're going to spend between $5,000 and $6,000 for that unit. That's brand new. Used, you're going to spend substantially less. CF33, same kind of situation, $3,000 to $4,000 brand new. You can get a refurb one from us, for example, for as low as $699. So if cost is a big factor, the refurb market is a place to take a look. The Getac V110 starts at $299. Brand new, this unit was $3,000. The FZ55, you're talking about $3,000 to $4,000 brand new. We got them used now for about $1,200. I think they're starting around $1,200. All of these units, it depends on your budget. So another thing you need to think about when buying a ruggedized laptop is the fact that there is different kinds of builds. And what I mean by that is they're built to different military standards. So you have fully rugged laptops that are built to a military standard that allows them to be dropped from a 6-foot height. It can handle extreme heat and extreme cold environments. Then you got the semi-rugged. Now, well, first of all, the fully rugged, you would have something like the V110 Getac or the Panasonic Toughbook CF33 or the Toughbook FZ40. Both of these are fully rugged. Semi-rugged in the Panasonic world is the FZ55, and in the Getac world it would be the S410 series. So semi-rugged, what's the difference? Well, semi-rugged isn't made with the same kind of metal parts that these units are made with. This still has some plastic bezeling, but I will say this is a vast upgrade from your standard retail laptop that you might purchase. You still get a certain amount of rugged ability, though. It can withstand some water spray, not like the fully rugged, but you can still get it wet. It still has a bit of vibration resistance, as well as drop. You can drop it. It may crack the bezel, but it'll still work. Also on semi-rugged, one advantage is you're going to get a larger screen. On the fully rugged, the screens are smaller. That's the difference between semi-rugged and fully rugged. So which one should you pick? That is the age-old question, and really, believe it or not, what it's going to boil down for you guys is, what are my requirements? What is my software's recommended specifications? And then, do I have a brand preference? A lot of people love Dell. Well, Dell makes a fully rugged laptop. I really like Panasonic. Then you would purchase one of the Panasonic Toughbooks. They have both fully rugged and semi-rugged. So it really boils down to your budget and which brand you like personally the best. Well, that's all I got for you this week, guys. Please leave your comments down below and like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next week.